If you need more GPM from your nozzle, you overpump to get more GPM. But how much do you have to overpump to actually get the extra flow rate that you want? Today, we'll take a look at how the working fire fixed flow nozzle with pressure relief stacks up against a standard 150 at 75 fixed flow nozzle. Here's the setup for today's nozzle comparison. Coming off the side discharge of this engine, we have 200 feet of 1¾-inch hose line integrated with a TFT show flow meter so we can see the flow rates in real time. So now we're gonna bring up our PDP to deliver about 150 gallons per minute out of the working fire fixed flow nozzle with pressure relief. And as you can see, we're flowing about 150 gallons per minute and our PDP is about 120 PSI. Now, we're gonna overpump to deliver 200 GPM. Now we're delivering 200 GPM out of the working fire nozzle and our PDP is about 180 PSI. So with this setup, about a 60 PSI increase achieves a flow increase of 50 GPM, flowing the working fire 150 GPM at 75 PSI fixed flow nozzle with pressure relief. Now we'll do the same test with a standard 150 at 75 fixed flow nozzle. Flowing about 150 GPM, as expected, our PDP is about the same 120 PSI. Now we'll overpump to 200 GPM, just as we did before. Now we're delivering 200 GPM with a standard 150 at 75 fixed flow nozzle, and our PDP is 210 PSI. So in this setup, a PDP increase of 90 PSI is required to get a 50 GPM increase. The working fire fixed flow nozzle with pressure relief wins the day again. When you need to overpump to get more GPM, the PDP increase to get a 50 GPM bump is 30 to 40 PSI less than a standard 150 at 75 fixed flow nozzle.
And because of the exclusive pressure relief feature, when you maximize GPM, you will always limit reaction force.
See the difference? Feel the difference? Schedule a time to flow the Working Fire nozzle today at theworkingfire.com.